Hi, today we are going to discuss about scrap, different types of scrap. Scrap is the material which is not meeting the quality standards. Okay, so there are three different types of scrap: assembly scrap, component scrap, operation scrap. So assembly scrap, we are maintaining the finished material master of MRP1 indicator. Basically these three scraps we are maintaining as a percentage basis, and component scrap we are maintaining in the raw material master in the MRP4 tab or bill of material of that component, and operation scrap we are maintaining in the bill of material of component or routing. So let us see assembly scrap. So 61 here, if you see example 61 is the finished material. For this finished material we are using two components, raw material 1 and raw material 2, and this is the total material cost, this is the quantity of the materials, and this is the price. And the machinery, machine hours are 10 and labor hours are 8. This is the price of machine and this is the labor price. Without scrap, if you are doing the standard cost estimate for this material, so this is the price we are getting. Okay, so when we are using assembly scrap, so assembly scrap is 10%, so that we are going to maintain in the finished material. So let us see that MM03 is the material master transaction code, 61 is the finished material which we are using. In the finished material MRP1 tab, we are going to maintain the assembly scrap. So this is, here we can see the assembly scrap. So this is maintaining only in the finished material master, not in the raw material master. Okay, so by doing this, the components which are using raw material 1 and raw material 2, these two components are going to increase 10%, and machine labor hours also are going to increase 10%. So total raw material quantity is 1.1 for raw material 1 and raw material 2, and machine hours are increased from 10 to 11 and labor hours increased from 8 to 8.8. So when we are doing the assembly scrap, so whatever components or activities we are using to do manufacturing of this finished material, it is going to increase with assembly scrap. So here we can see the total value. So this is the quantity into price of the material. Okay, so that is this one. This is the total material cost, and here percentage of, you know, overhead 20% on material cost. Here we can see, and machine, so 11 hours into 24. Here we can see the total value of machine, and total labor value is including assembly scrap. We can see here, this is the total price of the material when we are doing the assembly scrap. So this is about assembly scrap and component scrap. So component scrap, basically we are going to maintain in two places. So let me take you bill of material of finished material. So these two are the components we are using to do manufacturing of this finished material. 52, if you double click on this material MRP4 tab, we can see the component scrap. If you are maintaining component scrap in the material master of this raw material, so whatever finished materials are using this material as a component, so it is applicable in all the finished materials. So to avoid that, if you want to restrict component scrap only for one specific finished material, then we have to maintain that in the bill of material master. In the bill of material, if you see here, so here we do have a option to enter the component scrap. Here component scrap we have maintained. So when we are maintaining the component scrap in bill of material, then this component scrap is specific to this finished material only. Okay, so this finished material is using this raw material. Okay, so in this case system will calculate component scrap for this finished material process. Okay, now let us see the example. So component scrap, so 10% of component scrap. Here we can see component scrap, this is the total quantity of raw material, and component scrap is 10%. This is including component scrap plus quantity, so that is 1.1. so there is no component scrap for raw material 2, so the quantity is same as it is, and there is no change of activities also. Activities also, you know, it is same as it is. Okay, So if you see here 240, this is without any scrap, 240, 240 and 96. So by doing the component scrap, only for that material component scrap is going to calculate. Okay, so it is not going to have any impact on any other component or activity. Okay, but whereas in assembly scrap, it is going to have impact on all the components and activities which are using in the finished material. Okay, and the third one is operation scrap. So when we are using operation scrap, there are two places we can maintain. One is bill of material or routing. So now let us see. If you click on this one, here we can see the operation scrap, and here we have to select this net ID indicator if you are maintaining the operation scrap for this component, and which is going to override the assembly scrap. I am not going to maintain here. So there is another place we can maintain, that is routing. So in routing also we can maintain the component, sorry, operation scrap. So here we can maintain the operation scrap percentage. When we are maintaining the operation scrap, it is going to decrease the quantity of the next sequence operation. So let us see the example. So in this case, 51 is the finishing material. These two are the components I am using, and the total material cost as it is, and which is not going to have any impact on earlier quantity and in this operation. So let us see how it is going to be. CA03 51. I'm going to remove this group, enter. So there are two operations. If you double click on this first operation, if you come down, so this is the percentage of, you know, scrap which we are maintaining for operation 1, whereas for operation 2 it is not having any operation scrap. Okay, so we can see here no operation scrap maintained for operation 2. So when we are doing the standard cost estimate for this one or production, so if you see here, this is the total machine hours for operation 1, and this is labor hours and machine hours for operation 2, and labor hours for operation 2. So when we are using the operation scrap, there is no change in the quantity of raw materials which we are using, and there is no change in the overhead because it is same as it is. And machine and labor, so these machine and labor we have maintained. This is the first operation, so this operation we have maintained 10% of operation scrap. So this operation scrap 10% means it is going to increase. So 10% of 10, if you see here, 10% of 10 is 1, and here 10% of this is 0.8. so total is, okay, we can see here, so total mission hours for first operation is 11 including operating scrap, and the labor hours including operating scrap is 8.8. so we can see here. But when you go to second operation, so second operation quantity is 10 we have specified. Because of this operation scrap, it is going to reduce 1. Okay, because it is going to calculate here, you know, like 10 into percentage of this, and it is going to reduce. So this one 10 minus 1, so 9 it is going to come. So same like that here. Here we can see this is the calculation. Because of the operation scrap, the next operation the quantity is going to, hours are going to reduce. Because of that, overall product cost is going to have an impact. If you see here details, so reduce the quantity of subsequent operation. So subsequent operation is this one. So this is the subsequent operation. This is the first operation where we have maintained the operating scrap, so which is having impact on the subsequent operation, this one. So which has been reduced. Okay, so whereas this operation has been already increased, and it is going to reduce this operation. Okay, so that is about operating scrap. So now let us see in the SAP by creating assembly scrap and this component scrap both together. So this is the material I'm going to use to do production order creation. So before that, let us create standard cost estimate for that material, CK11. 61 is the material we are using. CK11 is the transaction code to do standard cost estimate for single material. So 61 is the material. Enter. So if you see here how it is going to calculate, we can observe. So there are two components we are using. So this is one raw material, this is raw material 2. So this raw material 1 is having both assembly scrap as well as component scrap. Raw material 2 is having only assembly scrap. And these are the activities. This activity is having total actual mission hours are 10, which is normal. But here assembly scrap, after adding assembly scrap, so it is increased from 10 to 11. So here also it is increased from 8 to 8.8 because of assembly scrap. So total price of this material is 646.80. Here we can see this is only assembly scrap. Okay, so now let us see here, this is the combination of both component scrap as well as assembly scrap. So 646.8, which has been calculated. So this is the combination of, you know, assembly scrap and the component scrap quantity, so along with the price. So this is the total we can see here. Okay, 0.11. So if you add these two, so total quantity we are using 1.21. This is the quantity for raw material 1, and for raw material 2 this is the quantity we are using, and we can see total price is 646.8. So I'm saving this. Now release the mark and release. CK24 is the transaction code, company code 61, remote test run, mark. So by doing marking, it is going to update in the material master plan price, and release, it is going to update in the standard price. Now let us see the material master where it has been updated. So now we can see the material master costing 2 tab. So this is the price which has been updated after releasing standard cost estimate. Now we will do the production order for this finished material. So one quantity I am going to enter, and start date and end date. So automatically it is going to increase the quantity because of assembly scrap. Here we can see the components. So this component 52 and 53, these two are the components which are using. So here we can see the requirement quantity which has been increased. So this is included both, and this is included only component scrap. So release and save. So now we can see the order number 120. Now do the confirmation of the production order. So 120 is the production order, actual data. So mission hours, it has been increased from 10 to 11. Labor hours increased from 8 to 8.8 because of assembly scrap. Save. By doing the confirmation, finance document is updating in S4 HANA along with the controlling document. Now we can do the goods issue of raw material to the production. So goods issue 120 is the finish production order number. So here, so we are going to give the storage location item. Okay, storage location of this item. Okay, and this one, enter, check, post. So now go to document, display. We can see the accounting document. Double click on this accounting document. Here we can see the total quantity of raw material 1, and this is the total quantity of raw material 2. Now do the goods receipt from the production. MIGO is the transaction code. Goods receipt 120. And as it is having scrap, I am going to receive one quantity for one storage location and remaining quantity to another storage location to differentiate. Save it. And now do the receipt of remaining quantity. to different storage location. Select item OK and save. Now do the actual overhead calculation KZI2. Remove test run and execute. So actual overhead is 10% on this material. Now WIP calculation. KKAX is the transaction code to calculate WIP. Remove test run. We don't have any WIP because we have done complete cycle. Now do the variance calculation, KKS2, execute. Now we can see the scrap, how much scrap it is going to calculate. So total is 0.122 for raw material 1 and raw material 2 is 0.11. This is for machine and this is for labor. So now if you see the calculation how it is going to calculate, now we will see. Okay. So here, this is the total, you know, scrap variances, which is having total scrap of that. If you see here, basically for one quantity, this is sum of 0.11 plus these three. So this calculation is happening including the scrap quantity which we are doing the manufacturing, that is 0.1. so on this 10% is okay 0.01, which is going to calculate. So this 0.221 is having both assembly scrap and component scrap, and this is included 10% of one quantity and 0.1% of assembly scrap. So now if you see here this one, so this is equal to this. So this is having the scrap quantity. So because the scrap quantity is, this is the scrap quantity which we are using and which is including these two, this one plus this one, assembly scrap plus these two, operation scrap 0.11, because the second material is not having any component scrap, so it is same. So in this case, in the raw material 1 case, so this raw material 1, here we are going to calculate, you know, 10% of this is 0.01. this is a scrap quantity, additionally we are doing the production. This is assembly scrap 0.1%. if you add these two, this one plus this one, means assembly scrap of for one quantity and scrap quantity 0.1, and this 10%, so total is 0.11. and component scrap is 0.1. so if you total do sum of these two everything, so if you see here scrap quantity, again here it is going to calculate the same scrap quantity in case of component scrap. So total it is going to do sum of all these things. So finally we will get this value 0.1221. this is for raw material 1, raw material 2, and this is for machine hours, total machine hours. So as it is not having any component scrap, it is going to calculate only assembly scrap. So for one quantity, so additionally we are using 0.1 and another scrap 0.1, so that is also going to do the assembly scrap. So total it is going to be 1.1 quantity additionally, and here it is going to be 0.88. so that we can see here. So 1.1 is additional quantity which we are using, and 0.880, which is additionally along with the scrap quantity, that is 0.1, we are using. So here we can see the details of that. And if you see the components cost element wise, so target cost, okay, so this target cost, how it is going to be calculated. So it has not been refreshed, so let me do that. KKS2 120, so now we can see target cost and actual cost and control cost. Control cost is the sum of actual cost plus WIP plus scrap. So the scrap, we know how it has been derived, so which is including scrap quantity also. And 11, this is having only component scrap, so 0.1, which is 11. this component scrap 0.1 also, including that. And this is the additional scrap overhead, how it is going to get. We can see in details of that. So let me show you that in the Excel sheet, how we are going to derive that. So if you see here, so 71168, so this is the total actual cost we are getting. And so here we can see this is a for raw material 1 and raw material 2, okay. And this one, target cost, this is the target cost. And here if you see actual cost, so where we are getting actual cost, so here we can see actual cost 623.70. so 623.70, here we can see this is the 10% of actual. If you click on this 623.70, which is deriving, so this target cost we are getting 711.48. so how this value is getting, this is the sum of 1.21 plus 10% of this, okay, because additional quantity which we are using total is 1.331. so this is the total target cost we are getting. So this is the scrap variance we can see, okay, in details. So target cost, actual cost, and the control cost is the sum of actual cost plus WAP plus scrap. So we can see scrap in details, what is the additional quantity we are using for raw material 1, raw material 2. This is the hours for machine, hours for labor, okay. So remove this test run and execute. Now go to settlement, KO88, remove test run, check transaction data, execute, details, sender. So if you see here, so price variance, quantity variance, input price variance, and scrap variance. So there are different categories are there in variance category. Okay, accounting document, we can see the accounting document how it is going to update. Input price variance, input quantity variance, remaining input variance. So if you want to know the details of this, there is a separate video for this variance, please go through that. So this is the way it is going to calculate scrap. And now we can see the production order. So here in the production order we can see balance of this production order, CO03, cost balance. So balance is zero after doing the settlement, balance of this production order is zero. So this is the way we have to do the calculation of assembly scrap, component scrap, and operation scrap.